it's important to distinguish Minoca from a true heart attack. The reasons for this are obviously the fact that the heart attack treatments and treatment for Minoca differs vastly. Prognostic implications of a heart attack are also very different from that of Minoca. When patients present with a heart attack, it is a potentially life-threatening condition and they require emergency treatment to unblock the clogged arteries. And that includes taking them to the cath lab, doing an emergency angioplasty procedure, insertion of a stent, and treatment with antiplatelet therapy. The treatment for Minoca, on the other hand, is different. You actually need to find out the actual cause will differ depending on the actual cause of Minoca. So it's important when somebody presents with symptoms mimicking that of a heart attack, but have been found to have no blockages, that the patient is investigated thoroughly to find out what the actual cause is. This may include cardiac MRI imaging, or further coronary imaging such as intravascular ultrasound and OCT. So it is important to determine this because symptom outcome does vary from person to person. In the past, when these patients present with symptoms of heart attack and has been subsequently found not to have any blockages, as physicians, we often think of these patients as having a good and favorable prognosis. Certainly, they do not have a prognosis as bad as those patients who present with a heart attack, but their prognosis is not benign. More recent research have shown that these patients too, they followed up over a 5 to 10 year period in various studies, have been shown to have a mortality rate of 5%. It's not as benign as we previously thought. So hence, patients who present with this condition should be investigated thoroughly and treated for as well.
Well, thank you for watching. I hope you liked the video. If you do, please don't forget to like, share, and comment. Thank you.